there by the by using that CVX solver developed by Boyd and Neil Parikh and others. So it is very much essential to know standard point of view. So before going to convex optimization problem, I will introduce a general, very general optimizer problem. Then I will discuss about a standard convex optimizer problem. Are you able to see the slide? Slide is visible or not?
Yes,
Okay, fine. So today it is a lecture number 20, in which we will discuss about introduction to optimizer problem, and further in more specific way that we will talk about a very standard kind of convex optimizer problem. And sometime of a convex optimizer problem is that solve a or minimize a convex function over a convex set. So ultimate you can say that it is the soul of convex optimizer problem, that we minimize a convex function, that we call it objective function, over a convex set. Over a convex set, that means such that X belongs to S. Here, F happens to be convex. And S is feasible set. S we are calling it feasible set, that also happens to be convex. The feasible set S is also convex. So minimizing a convex function over a convex set, we generally call it a convex optimization problem. But when you are going to solve this problem, definitely it is not easy to solve convex optimization convex objective function over a convex set. So we need to formulate in a very standard form. That standard form has been introduced by Boyd and Nestro and Nemirovsky, those kind of people. So mostly Russian people, they have introduced a very standard way to solve a convex optimization problem. So from solution perspective, because all about in CSE or EC, what ultimate job is to find the solution in computer. So that's way we need to introduce one standard form so that easily we can get a solution. So somehow, if we come to know that problem where F is convex, objective function is convex, and also the feasible set is convex, but it may not be in the standard form. And what we will do, we can reduce by applying some affine transformation or some linear transformation from linear algebra or some kind of operation. We can always reduce that problem to a standard form in order to solve that problem. So in that process, we are just imposing one equivalent criteria. That means a convex optimizer problem, which is not actually in a standard form, always can be reduced to a standard form. Once it is in a standard form, we can talk about solution. I have taken few example as well in order to see how we can reduce that. All these details, outline of my today's lectures are the following. First, I would like to discuss about general convex optimization, general optimization problem, and general framework I will give for optimization problem. Then I will go to here also in optimization problem, we will also introduce some terminology in order to solve the optimization problem. Solution means that what is the solution technique? Once we will come to know that that problem is having a solution, so that problem is having a solution, that mathematics always, mathematical analytical theory is always giving a guarantee of existence of solution of the optimization problem. Then next task would be what? How to find that solution iteratively. So there are many iterative technique. That one is part of last module, that time we will discuss in detail. And after once we will have an introduction of convex of introduction of optimization problem, we will talk about very standard form of a convex optimizer problem. Then I will go to discuss about from the example. I will take one convex optimizer problem which would be not in the standard form, but we can reduce into a standard form. So, and that convex a standard form. And I will talk about the optimality condition for local optima, then I will discuss in detail. So, coming to optimization problem, what does it talk about? So, a general framework of optimization problem is given here. So, how we can define a general framework of optimization problem? So, generally, whatever problem we are solving, so there are two kind of problem, either maximization problem or minimization problem. So, if you are doing minimization, then there is, it means that also you cover maximization as well. Like if you take a function, suppose you want to minimize x square. What is the domain of x square? It would be complete R. It is an unconstant problem. So if you want to minimize, then this problem is equivalent to what? Equivalent to maximization of minus x square. Here minus sign also will come here, this before that. That means minimum value of x square would be equal to negative or maximum value of minus x square. It is already and it looks very simple kind of things. So take another example, like because both will have same optimal value, those are 0, 0, 0. So better take another problem that would have other than 0, 0. So suppose you want to minimize the function x square plus 1. So it will have minimum value 1 at optimal point 0. So x square plus 1. So minimum value of this one would be 1. And so that means that we denote it by p star. Call it p star is the optimal value or minimum value of this one. So that p star, it exists at 0, and p, that optimal value is 1, and optimal point is that we denote it by x star. So these notations are very specific. X star is what? 0, because we are getting minimum value at 0. So this is the criteria. Similarly, if we are willing to find maximum of minus, that means negative f, what would be negative f? Minus x square minus f. Then what would be this lower function? It would be minus f. So what is maximum value of this one? Maximum value of minus x square minus 1 would be minus 1 or multiply with minus. So maximum value of minus x square minus 1, and you, when you multiply with minus 1, you are getting what would be that? That would be your 1. So call it Q star is also or simply you can call it you don't need a minus sign it here. You can also leave it in duality. I will discuss in detail that those concepts. So here, what is the maximum value of minus f? Maximum value of minus f is 1. That means Q star, that maximum value of minus x square minus 1, we are calling it Q star, that one is minus 1. And where does it exist? It exists at 0. So optimal point is 0. So what is the relation between the minimum value of f and minimum maximum value of minus f? We see relation is that P star equal to negative of Q star. So that is the relation. So definitely there is a relation. If you are going to minimize a function, then definitely there would be a relation with the negative of maximization of the maximization problem, because you will only study minimization problem. Why? Because convex optimization problem is having very interesting property. That property we are calling it that first order property of convex optimization problem, convex function, it says that a convex function is always bounded below by its tangent plane. So that's way, by utilizing that property, and we observe that there is always a lower bound of the convex function with respect to tangent plane, the convex optimization problem. But we are never talking about maximization of the upper bound of convex optimization, convex function. So that's why we will not discuss about maximization of a convex function. Is a very difficult task. So I am coming to general framework of the optimization problem. So it would be defined like this way. We have to minimize a objective function f naught. That's subject to constant f of I, either it would be less than equal to zero, or it would be greater than equal to zero, or it would be equal to zero to infinity m. So we may have m number, we may have more than one constant. So this part we are calling constant part. These are the constant part. This one we are calling it objective function. A special kind of condition that will exist only over the variable x. Objective function. These are just the optimization code. And if you f of x, it is a vector value function. And we can call it is a vector of functional constant. So every term is a functional. It defines a functional. So functional constant. So we are writing all like this way. Now here, if simply set S, we can call it feasible set. It would be the collection of the points. The collection of, remember, function. We are talking given constant. So feasible set. Remember that it is just intersecting point of the constant. Now we are coming to further classification. How can we classify optimization problem based on domain set? Or feasible set, based on feasible set. Suppose your feasible set happens to be a proper subset of Rn, then in that case we say that our constant is not defined throughout the Euclidean space Rn. It is just defined over a, we are cos a lot problem, but equal to, because we are taking function of several variables, that means function from Rn to R, function of several variables, simply you can say. Similarly, f I is where function from Rn to R. Okay, so if you equal to complete RN. In that case, the problem you can, we can call it the optimization problem will be unconstrained problem. And for unconstrained problem, optimality condition is very simple. Just find gradient equal to zero. But your constant, if you are having a constant problem, then you have to look optimality condition over feasible set, finite feasible set only, not complete RN. In that case, simply we at optimal point gradient may be non-zero. But in unconstrained problem, gradient would be always zero at optimal point. So those things we will discuss in detail. So a smooth, there optimization problem further we can classify as a smooth problem if it happens that all the component of the function, all fi's happens to be differentiable. Then the problem we are calling it a smooth problem. And if we are having a smooth optimization problem, then we can apply gradient descent. Because why? Because gradient descent demands for what? Demands for gradient or derivative of the existence of derivative of the function. So that's way. Also, you can apply for Newton method. Newton method also it is asking for existence involves a Hessian in a method to apply this method. Now non-smooth function, if any of the given function happens to be non-differentiable, any one of the given function happens to be non-differentiable, then simply we can't apply gradient descent or and Newton method. We can't apply for Newton method. Hessian, existence of Hessian is very important. That means for Newton method function must be twice differentiable, and for gradient function must be first differentiable. So those are a smoothness condition. So this condition, gradient descent, Newton method, we can apply our smooth function only. But our non-smooth function, we can't apply gradient descent or Newton method. What kind of method there are? So there are many methods. So one method you can say that subgradient descent, subgradient SGD, don't consider it as a stochastic gradient descent. So subgradient descent, then ADMM, alternative directional multiplier method. So all these are meant for non-smooth function. You can apply easily. So these are the technique for non-smooth problem. So there are many technique, algorithmic technique to solve problem, optimizer problem. Now coming to classification, further classification of the problem. We can classify a problem based on the linear nature of the constant. If suppose the constant, involved constant, happens to be linear function, that means affine function, linear function and affine function both happen to be similar kind of thing. So constant happens to be affine function, be written as a this affine function, EI transpose X plus BI. For I varies from 1 to m. So if every constant happens to be linear, then we will see that the optimization problem is linearly constant. In linear optimization problem or linear programming problem, you always observe that your constant happens to be linearly constant. Under the linearly, if you observe that under the linearly constant problem, you can always observe two a specific kind of problem. One problem that we are calling linear optimization problem. What does it mean? It means that apart from being your constant happens to be linear, your objective function is also linear. So everything looks linear. In that case, that problem, optimization problem, we are calling it linear optimization problem. And there is a very separate theory for linear optimization problem. We call it linear optimization or linear programming problem. So every linear programming problem always happens to be a convex optimization problem. So simply you can say that linear optimization is a sub-branch of convex optimization problem. Now further, if what happens, apart from being your constant linear, if your suppose your objective function happens to be a quadratic function, then the optimizer problem we will call a quadratic optimizer problem. Remember that for being a quadratic optimizer problem, your objective function would be a quadratic function. That means quadratic function, what is meaning of quadratic function? It will have a quadratic term, then a linear term, than a constant term. So this is the definition of quadratic form. We define it like this: x transpose a x plus a naught a trans a naught transpose x plus b naught. So this is your quadratic function, and the constant happens to be linearly constant. Then that kind of optimization problem we will call it quadratic optimization problem. Apart from that, if all fi are, that means all constant are quadratic, then the then the we will call it quadratically constant your optimized. We can get a problem, and these are all solvable problems. Already aware of simplex method, so there is a very interesting theory of simplex method. You can apply a lot here to solve linear optimization problem, and for quadratic optimization problem, similar theory also you can develop. Now, I will talk about classification of optimization problem based on feasible set. If suppose your feasible set is non-empty, that feasible set I had already defined like that, it is collection of all the points point satisfy the given constant, whether it would be less than equal to, or whether it is the constant is greater than equal to, or equality constant. That means whether it is inequality constant or equality constant. So all those points satisfy the constant, we are calling those points feasible points. So the collection of all feasible points we are calling a feasible set. So if suppose feasible set is non-empty, that means there exists at least one feasible point which satisfy the given constant, then the problem we simply call it a feasible problem. So this feasible problem we can express as an optimized problem like this way. We have to find x such that that those x satisfy this constant. So this problem simply you are not going to optimize a function, you are just finding point which satisfy this constant. So this one is one kind of problem, and that means you are just finding a set. It is one set. So this set is a feasible set. So it is a process of finding a feasible set. Equivalently, this feasible problem also can be converted into optimization problem. How? That means you minimize your objective function here. Your objective function is what? It is zero. Because you are just interested to find feasible points. So whatever objective function is meaningless. So that's why we intentionally we put it zero. If simplest one is zero, put it zero. That means we minimize zero in such a way x satisfy these constants. So this feasible problem also you can write like an optimizer problem. Now this condition is very interesting. I will discuss this conditions later. Condition once I will discuss I will introduce duality condition. What does it talk about? It talk about that the problem, optimization problem, that type of optimization problem, we will call it strictly feasible if there exists an interior point of the feasible set. Interior, x is the interior point. Remember that x is not a boundary point. It is an interior point. That means inside the set, it is not on the boundary. In such a way that the inequality constant satisfy, if there is inequality constant, then function satisfy inequality constant at the interior point strictly. Here only sign is less than. Either it's if there is inequality less than equal to condition, then the constant at interior point x satisfy strict inequality. If there is greater than equal to constant, then the corresponding constant function satisfy again strictly greater than point. If there is equality constant, then the interior point satisfy equality constant as well. So these this condition we are calling it Slater condition. It is very important in reality. Now, optimality of an optimization problem. So here, in order to further understand in a better way, we need to introduce two term in optimization problem. One is that we are calling it optimal value. So that means optimal value, we are calling it the minimum value or infimum of objective function f naught of x over the constant set q. Over the constant set q. That means the least value or the minimum value of objective function over the constant set q, we are calling it optimal value of the function. Provided it exists, and then the problem it is having an optimal set, then we call it a feasible problem. If suppose our feasible set is empty, that means there is no feasible point. Empty means there is no feasible point. That means the problem is infeasible. Then what would be your optimal value? It would be your infinity, because there is no point where the function will have a minimum value. So what is the minimum? Ultimately, we can say that infinity would be minimum value, because we don't have any feasible set is empty. So in that case, optimal value of the function would be infinity, and there is no optimum point. There is optimal value is infinity and there is no optimum point. That means there is no solution. If there are feasible points xk such that sequence with respect to xk, f naught of xk, it is converging to minus infinity as k is approaching to infinity, in that case your optimal value is minus infinity. And this is the scenario where we call it the optimization problem is unbounded below, because there is no finite bound. So that's why we are not getting a finite infimum or least value of the objective function. So it is a criteria that in this situation we are calling it unbounded below. This function is unbounded below. It is not bounded below. So that's why P star is taking negative infinity. Now, a feasible point x, we call it optimal point if value of the objective function at x it would be equal to optimal value. Then we call the feasible corresponding feasible point is an optimal point, and the collection of all those optimal point at a point, there may be more than one for a function, there may be more than one optimal point. Like if you are taking a convex function like this way, like this way, suppose. So here you can observe that, and this is the domain. Domain is R. So you can observe that in this interval, from starting from A to B, every point between interval A to B, we observe that the function is having least value, minimum value, and minimum value or same value, that we call it P star, optimal value P star. So here, the collection of optimal point, it is not a single point. What is that? Here, a collection of optimal point x opt, it is an interval a to b, x opt, x opt, or simply you can say that x opt, it is an interval. So when you are getting this kind of scenario, when your function is not a strictly convex function or a strongly convex function. So this one is just a convex function. And what was the criteria of being strictly convex? I had told that a function would be strictly convex if there is no any linear segment. So in this function, you can observe that this one is a linear affine segment. There is a linear affine segment in the graph of the function. But if you take a function like x square, we don't observe any linear segment for this function. So if this function is strongly convex, or further you can say that this function is strictly convex, and this function is having a unique optimal point. So what is the optimal point of this फंक्शन ऑप्टिमल पॉइंट इज जीरो. सो एक्स ऑफ टी इज ए सिंगलटन सेट हैविंग जीरो, दैट मींस पी स्टार इज टेकिंग जीरो वैल्यू एट ए सिंगल पॉइंट, दैट पॉइंट इज जीरो एंड पी स्टार इज हियर. What is the optimal value? Remember that collection of all optimal point we are calling it x op, and p star we are calling it optimal value. So p star is here 0. Here p star is what? That means optimal value is, suppose it is 1, it is cutting at 1. So p star is here 1. In the first problem, p star is 1. So this is the scenario of x op and p star. And further, we call x, the feasible point x is locally optimal if there exists an epsilon greater than 0 such that x is an optimal point in the local neighborhood of x. So that means this minimization problem is defined over in the local neighborhood of x. So we try to optimize this function in a local neighborhood of x. We are not looking in global sense, we are looking in local sense. Local, what is meaning of local? When there is a concept of neighborhood, then that concept we call it local concept. Whichever concept is defined with respect to look neighborhood or a small neighborhood, then that concept always we call it local concept. Similarly, derivative, whenever you define derivative, always we define derivative in a concept and define that neighborhood condition. Due to that, the point x would be locally optimal. But one interesting feature with the convex optimization is that every local optimal point for a convex optimization problem happens to be a global optimal. So there is no issue with the convex optimization problem. But if you are having a non-convex optimization problem, then there would be issue. Further, I would like to give two examples of optimization problem with corresponding optimal value. So if you are taking a function 1 by x, what is the domain of this function? Take domain of this function, positive real number. So here, this function attains optimal value when it will attain optimal value when x is approaching towards infinity. When x is approaching towards infinity, then the function will approach to zero. That means infimum of this function is what? Zero. That would be minimum value of the optimal value of the function. But we don't see any point where the function is taking zero. So we don't see. Infinity is not a real point. So that's why this function 1 by x, it is having an optimal value, but having no optimal point. Having no optimal point. This is the example of optimal value with no optimal point. Now, I'm taking one more example. Here the function would be unbounded below. Also, there would be no optimal point. So if you are taking minus log x, so a convex function. So what is the plot of 1 by x over this domain, positive real number? Plot is this one. So it is a convex function. So you can say that it is a convex optimization problem, but and also it is having an optimal value, but it is not having any optimal point. Now, minus log x, what is the plot of minus log x? So it is similar to that, it is coming like this way. It will cut x-axis at 1 and it will go like this one. This one is the plot of minus log x. So this function, you can observe that this function is not bounded below. It will keep on growing when x is approaching towards infinity, minus log x, it will approach towards minus infinity. So that's why we have written that yes, our optimal value is minus infinity. It simply says that the function is not bounded below. That means function is unbounded below, and also it is having no optimal point. Now, one example, this one is the nice example that entropy function. If you take negative entropy means what? X log 1 by entropy, we always define X log 1 by X. So this is the entropy. If you simplify, it will take the form X log X. So this negative entropy, it is again a convex function. Plot is similar to this. Plot would be like this. This is the plot of X log X, and where it has a optimum value or minimum value, because it is a convex, minimum value it will occur. So at this point there is a minimum value, and this is the optimal value or minimum value. This is the optimal value. But that means this is P star. P star is what? Minus 1 by E is the Napier constant, and optimal point is 1 by E. E, this is the optimal point. This is the optimal point, 1 by E. E is the Napier constant. So this one is very nice, that negative entropy is having optimal value as well as optimal point. Now, if you take a cubic function is what? Generally, it is unbounded kind of function. Cubic function happens to be unbounded. And why? Unbounded below. This function is unbounded below, and that's where the least value, minimum value of this one is minus infinity. Why? Because this function is unbounded below, cubic function. And domain of this function is R. So also you can say that it is unconstant problem. And also apart from unbounded below, it is having a local minima at 1, because derivative at 1 is 0. So that's where, so you can plot the function like this way. Plotting this polynomial function is very easy. What you do? Write this one in the factor form. So take X as a factor. So it will be X square. Inside would be X square minus 3. Further, you can factorize it, this one. So it would be X. Write in a very proper order. Minus. So X square minus 3, you can write it, you can factor it, X minus a square root of 3 into X plus a square root of 3. So I first I am writing it here, X plus a square root of 3 into X minus a square root of 3. So apply sine scheme process here in order to plot this one. Where would be 0, 0, this is the 0 point, your 0 factor is already a 0, is root of this function. And then there are two more root, one is a square root of 3, and another is negative a square root of 3. So what would we plot? So everything out, right up to a square root of 3 is positive. So it is coming like this way. But between a square root of minus negative 3 and 3, it is taking this kind of value, negative. So it is coming like this way. Plot is something like. Oh, this one is sine scheme. Okay, you can plot it like this. X square, X cube. So sign is changing. So here, when your positive sign outside, this one, this is the scheme, sign scheme process. You can plot simply this one. And when you are, so here in this side, X is greater than 3. So every term is positive. If you coming in this side, so what will happen? As this term would be negative. These two would be, this one is 0. So take it like this way. Sign scheme. So easily, I would like to say that you can easily plot this one. Sign scheme. So here, this one is minus 3, square root of 3. This one is 0.
one is a square root of 3. When a square root of 3 negative, then it will go 0 between a minus a square negative of a square root of 3 and 0, it would be again positive, then it will negative. So you can see that it is unbounded below. It will go like this way. So this is the sine scheme plot of x cube minus 3x, sine cube. So you can easily observe that after just in the right left of negative of a square root of 3, you observe that function is bounded below. So that's where this function is taking negative infinity as an optimal value or optimal value. That's where it simply say that this function is not unbounded below and it is having a local minima at 1. This is the local minima at 1. Also, local minima is also at coming between minus root 3 and 0 as well. But we are not interested to find local minima, local maxima. We are just interested to find local minima or minima. So local minima. So that's where this optimal, I am calling it optimal point 1. Okay. Further, one more interesting kind of concept is that implicit constant. So with respect to implicit constant, it is not affecting the unconstant problem. So so that's where I come with this one. What is implicit constant? So if you take a domain of the objective function along with the intersected domain of the constant, then this domain in together we are calling it a domain of optimization problem. And also it introduces a constant over the function. You take if log x, log x is what? This function is not defined throughout real number. It is defined where? In positive real numbers. That's where we call it domain of the problem. And that's where this condition is also behaving like a constant. But that constant is implicit constant. It is not explicit constant. What is the explicit constant? The constant which are coming after subject to. That means this constant we are calling it explicit constant. So an optimization problem without any explicit constant, we call it unconstant problem. An optimization problem which is having no explicit constant, we will call that optimization problem an unconstant problem. Whether that optimization problem is having implicit constant or not, if it is, that problem is having no explicit constant, then the problem we will call it unconstant problem. That is the criteria of an unconstant problem. That's where here one example you can look into here. So negative sum log. If you take negative sum log of this affine function, then what is the domain? You first you have to fix the domain. So what would be the domain? This one is a Fourier function, very interesting kind of function. In the one iterative technique that we are calling it a log must be positive. That's where you know when it will be positive, when you are defining this x you are taking from this lower half of space, a strict lower half of space. That means ai transpose x is less than bi, and here what does it will give? If you take for every I, if you plot, you will get a polyhedral kind of a structure. So this polyhedral kind of a structure, and along the boundary, these are the boundary given by the affine function. Along this boundary, this function is not defined. Why? Because along the boundary, this value would be zero. So due to zero component, definitely there would be one zero component. Due to zero component, log, what is the value of log 0? Log 0 of value is negative infinity, and negative infinity we are having negative outside, so negative, negative, positive, so it becomes infinity. That is the criteria of infeasibility. So that's why we are not taking points on the boundary, we are taking points in the interior, or only we are taking in the interior point. This function is defined interior point, and it is coming due to function's nature of the function or from the definition of the function. So that's where this constant we are calling it implicit constant, and this problem is having no explicit constant. So this problem is an unconstant problem, optimization problem. Next class we discuss in detail regarding convex optimizer problem, actual problem that we are going to solve here in this course. So we'll discuss convex optimizer problem and the method through which you can reduce a optimization problem into convex optimization problem. So those things we'll discuss in detail in next class. If you are having any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, I'm going to wind up to this class. And regarding attendance, go and mark your presence there in the Google Classroom. Any question?